It's 650 CE in feudal Europe. The serfs work the nobleman's land. They live in fear every day, but the knights keep the bandits away. Power and wealth now lies in land. Money's not worth much no more. There's no need to invest, and lords handle the rest, 'cause the king's got no power anymore. The kingship lost its power to the influence of the church. The Roman Empire was extremely corrupt and was ended by Germanic tribes, towards Rome by the Huns, which ignited endless conflict. Now Rome may have stood a chance had their government been intact, but it was split and falling apart, ruled finally by Romulus Augustus in 476. Charles Martel and his Frankish successors halted the Muslim advance. In France, during the hard-fought Battle of Tours, then the Pope made a large mistake by crowning Charlemagne. This made the Byzantines mad.
Seljuk Turks conquered the Holy Land, and the Christian church wanted it back. So the Pope had Christian knights travel there to fight for what they thought was theirs. And the Pope declared a holy division between the Eastern and Western Church. Those on the East followed Eastern Orthodox, while the West were Roman Catholic. A new cultural movement is starting from the 14th century. It started in Italy, and the rest of Europe trailed behind. Art and literature are appreciated. New philosophies are being brought to life. Petrarch is preaching humanism, optimism based on the good of men.
One day a man named Machiavelli made up his mind on how to rule. Wrote it down in a book called The Prince. He thought that rulers must be very strict. With his violence and oppressive controlling is the only way to keep kings surviving. Cheat, steal, lie, kill everyone's your enemy. Humans are the worst of all. On the flip side, artists and sculptors love life to gain pleasure in the world around. And there's new men in town writing out the things that they thought and painting everything they felt. Now things are getting extreme. Dante wrote some grand poetry, Da Vinci made great works of art. More than that, he made advances in science during the late 15th century. The original anatomist and expert engineer, he was a Renaissance man. But now Russia's stuck in Mongol slow development, but still they were influenced.